I don't like early mornings. I think I'd like mornings better if they were a little bit later. Two and a half hours later, I have arrived. So a quick lunch before we start to rehearse. Let's see if I can find this place. Nope. So this is where we're gonna rehearse. A pretty big room so we can keep our distance. I need to find some more sheet music stand, I think, because the songs I'm gonna play are on several pages, a lot of pages. So let's see if I can find it. So I did find a sheet music stand for this. This is the sheet music I have to read, and it's so many pages. There's three singers and me. I'm the piano player, and we're gonna do a show from musicals. So we're gonna do musicals numbers and try to make one show from all those numbers. And the piano parts on this is transcriptions from the orchestra. So it's so much to read, and therefore I had to rewrite every piano part because I can't read like 19 pages on one song. Maybe I can fit 4 pages on one stand. So I have to rewrite it all. So I have some work to do. But I also had time to meet Håkan.
And there he is, the infamous Håkan.
Hello, everybody!
A burger in Sweden.
Good stuff.
I'm having lunch with Håkan, and we're discussing live streaming on Facebook and such, and... What are you saying?
It's a difficult theme to discuss that we have live streaming on the Facebook and other social media.
Do you think that people are getting used to live streaming on Facebook so they get comfortable, they get the entertainment without doing it without doing anything themselves?
Yeah, because now we can pick up the phone, the laptop or whatever you want, and you don't need to go out to get the music. So I think we're going to have some problems the day when this ends and we're going to go out and play.
I'm also wondering how it is with rights, copyrights of songs. If you're playing cover music on Facebook, is that legal or not? Comment down below if you know anything about this. Yeah. Do you know anything about the rights?
Nothing at all, because it's a really tough question that we need to discuss if it's legal or not, yeah.
Yeah. And then we went to my studio because we're co-writing a song together. And if you're wondering how we can be so close to each other, I felt rather safe because Håkan was sick in COVID the week before we met, and he had been totally isolated.
Om man ska ha något stick där, eller vad man ska kalla det för, eller brygga eller vad som helst.
Ja, men det är det jag menar, att stick behövs där.
Skulle man kanske köra ett, alltså om man gör ett solo där bara?
Och måste vi?
So Håkan came to me with an idea of a song and asked me if we could finish it together. So what we did here was to make the song structure, the melody, the chords, a little bit of the rhythm, and try to figure out how long every part should be, how the melody and the intensity of the song should be, the energy, if we had to take it down somewhere and up somewhere. And we wanted the chorus that really lifted the song. So we worked a lot with that.
Det beror också på hur det ser ut med texten, ifall det behövs berättas någonting mer.
Nej, precis. Det där är ju jävligt snyggt. Ja. Att vända när vi kommer på nu är ju fantastiskt.
Ja, det är skitsnyggt och jag tror att det passar svinbra till det andra också.
Tre helt olika saker i samma låt.
Ja, och det är bara tre.
Ja.
Jag tror inte det behövs mer.
And then we did some scratch recording of the song. I just programmed some drum loop. And Håkan played his guitar part. We recorded first the verse. Then we did the pre-chorus separately. And then we did the chorus separately. And then we did the bridge separately. So we can move around the blocks and see how the structure of the song fit together. And finally, we did some scratch vocals without any lyrics. Because some people I know do some scratch lyrics also when they do the scratch vocals, but I don't want that. I want a total open mind when I'm starting to write the lyrics. Na, 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 na. We discussed a little bit what the song could be about.
Ska det vara miserabelt? Ska det vara miserabelt?
Yeah.
But nothing is finished, nothing is for certain yet. And the song isn't finished yet. We will tweak the chords, we will tweak the rhythm, we will tweak the melody to make the song as good as we can. I think this is a great way to write songs together. One person comes with the main idea of the song and then we finish it together. It's like brainstorming. Sometimes when you speak out the words yourself loud, you hear how ridiculous they are. And sometimes you come with great ideas and everything is fine. This was very smooth. I think both of us understood each other and both have the same sort of goal with the song. So how do you write your songs? Do you write them by yourself? Or do you take help from others? Are you in a band maybe that's writing the songs together as a group? Please leave it in the comments and let us all know. The Swedish word of today. Håkan works mainly as an entertainer. Entertainer in Swedish is underhållare. Underhållare. And Roger that. Without any lyrics.